Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On this episode, let's take a look at the digital color meter utility on your Mac. So the digital color meter is a little app that comes with your Mac. You'll find it in your applications folder under utilities, and there it is. Or you can just search for it like I do with Spotlight. When you run it, you just get this little window here. It doesn't really seem to do too much. It just will show you what color is underneath the cursor. So for instance, let's bring up Safari here. And say you're looking at a web page, like the Mac Most page here, and you want to use a color. Say you're working in Photoshop or some other image editing tool, and you want to grab a color that you see, like say this red that's being used here on this text. You want to find out exactly what color that is. So you bring up Digital Color Meter, and notice that whatever the cursor is over, I see an enlarged version of it in Digital Color Meter. So I can go over here and I can look at this letter right there, and I can see exactly what pixel it is I'm looking at, and it gives me the values, RGB, red, green, and blue values for that specific pixel. Now that's only somewhat useful because most people don't use RGB values for things. So I find if you go in to View and you change display values to hexadecimal, then you get RGB, but you get these hexadecimal values, which you'll recognize if you do any kind of web development or work in Photoshop or anything. You can see that the color here would be 942F35, for instance. And that's a lot more useful than seeing the colors as numbers. You can also change the aperture size. So instead of wanting to get, say, a single pixel, you can change it and grab a group of pixels and see what kind of the average color is between that group. And you can see the big swatch here, this part, actually gives you the single color that matches everything that's there. So you can kind of get like a general idea of like all these together to the eye look like this one individual color here. And you can adjust this to pretty large size as well, or you can go back down to a single pixel. Now if you find a color you like, you don't have to just rely on remembering it or writing it down. There are two ways to copy it. If you look here, you can do color, copy as text, or copy as image. Now you don't want to ever use the menu here because your cursor is going to move. So you want to remember the shortcuts Shift Command C and Option Command C. So let's try Shift Command C, grabbing this red here. Shift Command and C will copy it. Now I'm going to go over to Text Edit here and I'm going to paste. And you can see it pastes it there. Now it's pasting as hexadecimal because I've changed the display to display hexadecimal. If I still had it set to the decimal values, then I'd get three numbers here instead. This is far more useful, and I can paste this directly into a lot of image editing programs that allow me to change the color of the fill or the line or whatever. So it's very useful for that. Now let's try the other one. Let's try using the Option Command C, or right here, copy color as image, and we'll do that and we'll see what we get. Now I'm going to get an image here, so I can paste that into TextEdit, but it's not as useful. I'm going to go into Pixelmator here and I'm going to paste, and you can see it pastes this rectangle here that's a solid color rectangle. So this can also be useful for a variety of different things, for stretching this over a background or just be able to grab it using the Eyedropper tool in different image editing apps. There are a lot of other cool options here. For instance, the ability to lock the position and also do a bunch of different things like lock X and Y. So I can lock the position, and let's try that. If I get a color I want, I can do Command L, and now you can see I move and it doesn't move with me. So it's a good way to capture that, and I can just do Command L and it unlocks it. So you can capture that, or I can do Command X. And now I can move up and down on a row here, but I won't be able to move left or right. I can switch that to Command Y and it's locking both. And I can turn off Command X, and now I can just move this way and turn off Command Y, and now I can move around like that. You also have the ability to look at things in slightly different color parameters here. I'm not an artist, so I don't really use these. I just stick with the native values to find out what the color is. Really is set to by the code or in the image itself. And one last little thing I want to point out is this show mouse location function. It has nothing to do with color, but it gives you the X and Y coordinates of the location of the mouse. This is useful for developers for a lot of different reasons to be able to exactly locate something on the screen and its position there.